Friends of Abby Lincoln's would come up to the house and I would braid their hair. Red Fox, Flip Wilson, all those kind of people. And I was just braiding it, fat braids, you know.
Rosa Johnson's career as a hair sculpturist began in California over 40 years ago. Today, her living room in Winston-Salem is a gallery of hair design, a real head turner.
One of my students in Los Angeles, she was my best student. She sent these in.
And this is called what now?
She calls them glory heads. And the wrapping, that's thread.
Her students' artwork, which also includes these redefined Barbie dolls, will be on display Saturday as part of Johnson's exhibit on African ancestral hair sculpture. She was first introduced to African art by her aunt, the legendary poet Maya Angelou, and that became her inspiration.
Those are great photos.
Grammy-winning singer-songwriter Stevie Wonder was Johnson's client for about a dozen years. He would sit for hours as she braided his hair with 5 to 7 pounds of beads.
Over the years, his hair got tender, and we'd have to go to his dentist, and they would put him out on anesthesia. So I asked him one time, why are you doing this? You know, it hurts you, you know. He said it made him feel like a king.
Johnson says she wants people to know that hair braiding is a royal experience rooted in rich history.
A lot of people think that Bo Derek started braiding. Now, one of my students braided Bo Derek's hair. Well, a lot of young people and older people really don't know the history of this art form. So we have been studied by other people, but I think it's important now for us to know who we are and where we come from.